The only way I can stand living here, the only way I can tolerate is if Casey...
Hold on. I'm sorry, sweetie. I gotta take this.
It's all right.
Emily, what a surprise. There is no reason to get nasty, okay? I know we're in this together. I have not forgotten that, Emily. And I have done everything humanly possible to live up to my end of the bargain. Now, I can't talk about this right now. Okay, we'll discuss it later. Fine, I'll see you there. Great.
What was that all about?
It's wrong number.
And are you in trouble again?
Yeah,
don't lie to me.
Nothing that you need to worry about.
Is that one of those irons you claim to have thrown in the fire? Looks like it's getting a little hot.
Not too hot to handle, Madeline. You were talking about Casey.
Yeah, I was. What was that? What, are you spying on me now?
How can I be spying on you when this is my house?
Oh, okay, so then what do you call lurking and overhearing then?
You know, I was getting a book. I could care less what you and your brother are talking about.
Oh. Even if what we were talking about is you? Or more specifically, how you two can learn to get along?
No, we were not talking about that, because it's not possible. We can't get along.
Oh, Maddie, Coleman's never say can't.
You do all the time.
Well, do as I say, not as I do. I've got to get going, kids. Now, you two play nice, okay? Bye-bye.
Don't let me stop you if you need to find your book. Just don't try and tell me that you're... What was it again? Oh, yeah, you suddenly had to come out and take the garbage out when Nate was here.
You know what? I did have to take the garbage out.
No, you were trying to make Nate never come over here again.
Fine, whatever. You want to keep blaming me because your love life can't get off the ground? Whatever. I just don't have time to listen to it because I have a test.
You have a test and you're studying for it now? It's practically midnight.
What do you care?
I don't. But when you get caught... snoring with your mouth wide open in the middle of an exam? Don't say I didn't warn you.
You're the one who's going to be zoning out in class. You're usually lights out by 10:30.
How do you know when I turn my lights off?
Because every night I secretly pitch a tent up outside your door and I listen to you breathe. Your bedroom's on the way to the bathroom, genius. I can see if your light's on or not.
Well, I'm sorry if it disturbs you.
Oh, I'm disturbed. You're the one begging your brother to find you another place to live.
That's because I don't have any privacy here.
Okay, so it's just a privacy thing, nothing personal.
What else?
I don't know. I just can't seem to shake the memory of somebody telling me I was a worthless creep who lies about getting girls pregnant and would never be half the man Nate the Great is.
I apologize for that.
Did you mean it?
I shouldn't have thrown the whole Gwen thing in your face. You've made up for a lot of it.
Gee, thanks. I didn't realize you were giving out report cards.
And I didn't realize you were so sensitive.
What, guys like me are too shallow to feel anything?
Casey, I didn't say that.
No, you didn't have to. Tonight showed me where I stand as far as you're concerned. You know, and don't worry about your privacy because... just because we live together doesn't mean we need to speak to each other. And, you know, we don't even need to look at each other if that's the way you want it. And don't worry, I won't be checking under your door to see if your light's on.